Around 1860, Thomas Woods left his parents' farm and walked 5 kilometers through bush to land near approaches from the Canadian Company. He built a house and barn which was all done by axe. As his family grew, he built a new brick house and a paint barn. This is the farm that I live at today. Good morning, judges, fellow contestants, and ladies and gentlemen. Today I would like to speak to you about what the next generation of agriculture is bringing to the table. This story about Thomas Woods is just one example of the awesome history of agriculture in Canada. When I hear stories of these pioneers of Canadian agriculture, it seems that it must have been such an exciting time. There were opportunities all around for those who were willing to work hard. It is easy to feel that these were the golden years of agriculture in Canada, and that opportunities like these no longer exist. However, I am going to speak to you about some of the exciting things that today's generation of farmers are bringing to the table. First, the next generation bring a passion for farming. Many have grown up on farms and have seen what a rewarding life farming can be. They bring a new energy and new idea on how to improve. They tend to be highly educated and are choosing to come back to the farm after finishing their education. They look at farming as a privilege, not a burden. I myself hope to be able to farm someday. I love touring different farms with a 4-H group and seeing how different people are choosing to farm. It is exciting to think of all the possibilities in agriculture right now. Along with their passion for farming, the next generation bring a real concern for the environment. If we want to keep farming for many generations and keep feeding a growing population, we must be concerned with protecting the farm, land, water, and air we breathe. Young farmers are looking at new ways to reduce soil erosion, increase crop yields, improve animal health, and reduce their carbon footprint. One way they are doing this is by increasing technology. The old image of a farmer in the field with a saw hat and a pitchfork just isn't the farmer today. Today's farmers are using drones to crop scout, check on livestock, they are using GPSs in tractors and even self-driving tractors. Dairy farmers are using robots to milk and keep stables clean. In the field, research is developing crops that require less spray and produce higher yields. In the maple syrup bush, all old machines mean far less fuel is required to make the maple syrup for your pancakes. These are just a few of the innovations being used today by young farmers. This generation has also embraced social media as a way to inform and interact with the public. Facebook and Twitter are great tools to counteract some of the negative messages about farming, such as misinformation about genetically modified food and animal welfare concerns. They also use it as a way to network with other farmers around the world. In the U.S., social media activity of farmers between the ages of 18 and 35 is 76%. Dating back to Thomas Woods and his trip through the bush to claim his land. Many young people today may feel that there are no opportunities to get into farming if you aren't going to inherit a farm. However, there are innovative ways that young people are coming up with to get into farming. This spring, I was lucky to visit Underhill Spets with our 4-H, Ear and 4-H Beef Club. Here, Jordan and Donna Underhill breed Spectral Park cattle. They have a 100-year lease on a farm near Elmira. Because they haven't had to invest a huge amount of money in buying the farm, they have been able to invest in their buildings and livestock. So there are still all ways that young people are coming up with to get into the ag business. Canada's Outstanding Young Farmers Program recognizes young farmers between the ages of 18 and 39 who are doing amazing things in the field of agriculture. Reading through some of the past winners is really inspiring. One of the winners are Andrew and Jennifer Lovell from New Brunswick. The Lovell story is different because neither of them grew up on a farm. In 2012, they purchased their farm, Riverview Orchards, and created a diversified U-pit farm market operation. It wasn't an easy start as they suffered $100,000 in damage in 2014, but they persevered and adapted their plans until they were able to begin full production up again by offering fence and Travis construction services and building attractions which brought over 1,400 visitors to their farm. They were able to continue on with the farm that they had always dreamed of. These are just a few of the examples of the exciting things that are happening in Neanderthal. I believe that when you look at what the next generation of Neanderthal is bringing to the table, the future of Neanderthal is bright.